Okay, in this tutorial, I'm going to show you how to import a WordPress database properly in a Godaddy hosted setup. There's a couple different ways to do this, but generally you are going to want to use PHPMyAdmin, which is a tool that allows you to get direct access to the website database. So I'm in my hosting screen here within Godaddy. Yours might look different, but most of them will have the ability to do this. As long as you're not one of those WordPress only hosting, you should be able to do this pretty easily. If you have cPanel hosting, you're going to look in here and find PHPMyAdmin. This in theory should also work for me. Otherwise, I like to go directly to the database I'm looking for. So if I click databases, go to the database I'm working on, then you can just click PHPMyAdmin and it'll load it up. So it actually pops up a new tab here. And it may ask you to log in, so hopefully you have your credentials for your database, but mine already is logged in. So on the left here, I've got the database I want to use. Make sure you click that first. Now, just a word of warning, make sure you back up your database before doing anything like this, and then make absolutely certain you are on the correct database, because we're actually going to be dropping the entire thing. To be extra sure, even if you've already backed it up, you might want to click export and click that and actually export an entire file of the one you're on, just in case. But I know we've got one, so what I'm going to do is first you have to drop the existing tables from your database. So you're not deleting the entire database, but you are removing everything from inside. So click check all with selected drop. You have to remove all this before we can import the database file that we're using. So I'll double check, you click yes. So there, everything was dropped successfully. So now let's go back to our database. See, there's nothing in it now. So now we're gonna click import. It's basically the opposite of the process we did before. So click choose file. I'm gonna go to downloads here. Now I've got two files here that I created using two different means. I believe this one is created using a plugin and this one is created with PHPMyAdmin. Whether it's in a zip or not actually doesn't matter. It'll figure it out. So I'm going to click that zip. Just click open. And the rest should all just be set. Then click go. It's going to upload the file. I guess in this case, this one is complaining about that zip file. It could be, this is a little bit older hosting. It could actually be have a setting that doesn't allow the zip file. So you could just extract this one, or in this case, we'll just use this file. So if you have any recent or newer hosting, odds are you're not gonna have that issue. Okay, so I uploaded the new one, I clicked go, and there it went. So it completed successfully. It looks like we've got all our same tables here, and all of the information should be in there. So that's really all there is to it. There aren't really a lot of good ways to import a database using plugins within WordPress. And the reason for that, I'm sure you can understand, is that they'd have to be overwriting kind of themselves. So there's a lot that could go wrong there. So you really need to have access to the database directly. With that being said, there are other tools as well that would work. So for instance, if you are migrating your website, you can use a tool called Duplicator, and that is a WordPress plugin, though when you're importing, it creates files for you. You're not actually in WordPress yet. But anyway, yeah, that's just a quick and easy tutorial. Let me know if you have any difficulty with that.